The MRI essentially shows two separate views of the spine, a side view, or a sagittal view, and a bottom-up view called the axial view. On the side view, we literally take a samurai sword and we slice the spine like a loaf of bread into different sections, and that is represented by this side view here on the MRI. The bottom-up view is essentially axial slices, and you can see here the disc, which would be located right here, the center of the canal here, where you see the nerves, and then the two facets on either side in the back, which is represented on the MRI here and here. Now we're going to examine a normal lumbar spine. We have two views of the spine. We have the side view here, and we have the bottom-up view here. On the side view, you can see that this side view corresponds to this line in the cut of where we are cutting the spine in half, literally. So if this arrow or this line is right in the center of the spine, this is the center cut of the side of the spine. We can move this line anywhere, and we can see cuts, for example, to the side of the spine here. We can move these lines to get to the other side of the spine there. So this line that we're looking at on the right side indicates where the cut is on the side of the lumbar spine here. To get to the anatomy, this is the spinal cord. The spinal cord ends about right here, and then the spinal cord exits into the cauda equina, which are the peripheral nerves which sit in the center of the canal. We don't see the nerves coming all the way down because they start to exit. If I move this cut over to the side, you can actually see the individual nerve roots on one side. We go back to the center and then cut on the other side, and again you can see the individual nerve roots on the opposite side. The white material in the center here is cerebral spinal fluid, which is essentially water. On this particular scan, called a T2 scan, water is white. You can also see the fat in the back here. The fat is also white, mimicking the water. These are the vertebral bodies that I'm circling here, and in between the vertebral bodies are the discs. The vertebral bodies are named for the five lumbar segments. So this is L1, L2, L3, L4, and L5. The lumbar spine, as we talked about before, sits on the sacrum, and this is the sacrum. The sacrum has some vestigial discs, but they're not relevant, and this is really one bone. We name the discs for the vertebra they're sandwiched in between. So for example, this is the L5 vertebra, and this is the sacrum we call S1. So this is the L5-S1 disc. As we go up, this is the L4-5 disc, the L3-4 disc, the L2-3 disc, the L1-2 disc, and the T12-L1 disc. We're now in the thoracic spine. The vertebra themselves have a normal grayish hue, which is a little indeterminate. And that's what bone looks like, which is filled with osseous structures and with fat. The edges of the bone on the sides, you'll see these little black and white areas. These are where the veins of the bone exit, called the basivertebral veins, and they're normal. If we follow back here, we can see the spinous processes of the vertebra in the very back, and in between we see both muscle and ligament that hold these vertebral processes together. We can take the side and come to the outside where the nerve holes are, and now we can visualize the bony tunnel called the foramen where the nerve exits. In this case, this is the L2 nerve sitting in its white fat, which is nature's packing, in the L2-3 foramen. Here is the 3-4 foramen, and this is the L3 nerve right here in its fat packing. Here is the 4-5 foramen with the L4 nerve sitting in its fat packing, and the L5-S1 foramen with the L5 nerve there. We can conversely go to the opposite side and see the exact same thing with the nerve roots exiting out the foramen. If we then go to the top-down view here, we can look at the angulation and cut of the spine and visualize the spine as what it would look like if you took a samurai sword and looked up at the spine from there. We're going to start at the L5-S1 disc. At this view, this is the dural sac, the sac of nerves. All these black dots within this white sea of water are the nerve roots, and these are the nerves that have already exited out of this sac. These nerves exit like branches on a tree. So this is the 5-1 level, and as we march up, we then get to the 4-5 level. The 4-5 level here, you can see the normal disc, which has the jelly on the inside, the outer plies of the tire on the outside, the back of the disc being either flat or a little concave, all of the nerve roots sitting in the area here of the dural sac, and then these are the two facets in back. Some people say that facets look somewhat like hamburgers with the buns, where you have the meat and a little mustard on the inside and the two buns on the outside. These are normal facets. We can march up then and go to the next level at 3-4 and again see the same thing. The jelly-filled donut, the outer plies of the tire, the sac of nerves. If we get a little higher, we can see the actual facet joints, and this is a normal level. We can continue to go up and see more. Here is the basal vertebral vein and some of the veins within the vertebral body itself. So when you look at these images, these are normal.